Mr. Simon, you described The Empire Strikes Back, the second in this trilogy, as malodorous awful, and I understand you're also well able to keep your enthusiasm in check for the third in the trilogy. Why so unkind?
I feel they're so bad because they're completely dehumanizing. Obviously, let's face it, they are for children or for childish adults. They're not for adult mentalities. It's like flesh and blood there. You have three lousy actors in the main roles who don't contribute much flesh and blood. You have ghastly dialogue, terrible plotting, miserable characterization, which also do not contribute flesh and blood. So what you're left with is something that Walt Disney could have done just as well with a drawing board and pencils and colors.
There is no sense that this ebullient, youthful saga is running thin in imagination, or that it has begun to depend excessively in its marvelous special effects, that it is in any danger, in short, of stiffening into mannerism or mere billion-dollar style, The New Yorker. You're likely to find more beauty, suspense, discipline, craft and art when watching a New York Harbor pilot bring the Queen Elizabeth II into her Hudson River. The Empire Strikes Back is about as personal as a Christmas card from a bank, the New York Times. I found myself glancing at my watch almost as often as I did when I was sitting through a truly terrible movie called The Island, the New York Times. Familiarity breeds content. From the corny droids to the tired and emotional Wookiee, the events, recognitions, and revelations of the sequel have the rhythm of the television show soap. Time out.
All right, Roger.
The princess. You have to take care of her.
The more one sees the main characters, the less appealing they become. Luke Skywalker is a whiner. Han Solo is sarcastic Claude. Princess Leia and Nagin C-3PO just a drone. Nor will the acting of the performers who play them stand much scrutiny, People magazine.
I love you.
I know.
The characters take a definite backseat to the special effects, and much of the action seems gratuitous, leading nowhere. Irvin Kershner directed the actors this time around, and without the benefit of Lucas's personal affection, they seem stiffer. Chicago Reader. The force is with us, indeed, and a lot of it is hot air, the New York Times.
You have three lousy actors in the main roles who don't contribute much flesh and blood. You have ghastly dialogue, terrible plotting, miserable characterization, which also do not contribute flesh and blood. So what you're left with is something that Walt Disney could have done just as well with a drawing board and pencils and colors.